Hello horse fans, life skillers, grinders and other people alike interested in horses. Welcome to this video comparison thing race of a tier 8 versus a tier 6. Best intro 10 out of 10. I don't know what to say for an intro, so that works. Basically, the whole idea of this video is to compare a tier 8 that has instant acceleration to a tier 6 horse that only has the regular instant acceleration. I kind of asked myself this question a couple of days ago, what is the real difference between these two horses, because I played this game for a long time and I played with my tier 6 for over a year until I finally managed to snipe a tier 8 from the horse market, and up until I had that tier 8 in front of me, I never thought that a difference is anything significant. I thought it's just simply an incremental upgrade, maybe 10% faster, something like that. And I think some of you might be under that impression as well. Maybe some of you have a tier 6 and want to upgrade to a tier 8, or maybe you already have a tier 8 horse and just simply want to know the number itself, how much faster it is. For whatever reason, let's race the two horses and figure out what is the difference. Before the race begins, I would like to point out that I made sure this is as fair as possible. I moved both my gear and my horse costume from my tier 8 to my tier 6 to make sure that both horses have the same gear and the same costume. Yes, the costume gives you some movement speed as well. So realistically, the only difference is that one is tier 6 and the other is tier 8. Besides that, there's only one real difference that matters in some way, which is the fact that my tier 8 doesn't have sprint. When I bought it, I didn't consider that to be something significant, and I still don't, because most of us spam the drift cancel anyway. For those of you who don't know how sprint works or what it does, here is a clip to understand it easier. It's much easier than me explaining it into words. But to give it a try, how I would explain it is, if you have sprint, after you use instant acceleration, the horse is going to maintain its fast motion. Basically, it moves fast, while if it doesn't have sprint, the horse is going to slightly slow down after the instant acceleration animation is over. So it's only relevant if you don't cancel drift. Most of us cancel drift, and to make this comparison fair, both horses will be canceling drift over and over, so sprint is irrelevant. Now, with that all being said, I guess the race can begin. For the racetrack itself, I start from Hydel and I'm going all the way to Sun Green Bazaar as fast as possible. I did stick to the road, which, yes, it's very important to keep this track actually the same for both horses. I know most of you, when you ride the horse actively, we tend to take as many shortcuts as possible, often going off-road just to get to the destination as fast as possible, but in this case, I had to stick to the road. Other than that, I don't think there's much else to say. In the middle, you can see my tier 6 sprinting. On the right is my tier 6 spamming drift, and on the left we have the tier 8 also spamming drift. The reason why there are three clips is because I want to show you that if you have sprint, you don't really need to spam the drifting, the drift cancel over and over. That's why I have two clips for my tier 6 horse. I'm not sure if this is different for a tier 8 horse that has the double instant acceleration, but for my tier 6, as you will see at the end of the race, the difference is pretty much inexistent from the sprint clip and the drifting one. That's pretty much it. I will probably put some background music to fill in the time, because I don't want to speed up the footage at all. I want it to be as it is in game, normal speed. And I guess I will see you at the end of the race. Until we get there, I have one request for those of you who are interested to participate in this. I just figured it might be an interesting idea. Before you see the number, if you didn't skip to the end of the video already, would you be just leave a comment with your guess exactly how much faster do you think the tier 8 is going to be compared to a tier 6. You can put something like it's going to be 10% faster, 15% faster, 20% faster. Just put a number, just as a mini game, I suppose. And at the end of the video, see for yourself if you were under the right impression or if the number is higher or lower than you think it will be. Honestly, I'm just curious for myself to see what most people thought of the difference between the two horses, but you know, it might turn out to be something interesting. In any case, I will see you at the end of the race.
Over the edge, feel like I'm floating through the air. I felt it's paid for, all is said and done. Oh, I am restricted, fixed upon the web. I need to kick the habit that my mind is breathing in. Break out, I've got to see. Spent all my life holding all of it closely. I played it.
So here we are at the end of the race. As most people expected, the tier 8 arrived first in about 3 minutes and 38 seconds. The second one was the tier 6 drifting with 4 minutes and 40 seconds, an entire 1 minute longer, and then the tier 6 sprinting just simply 2 seconds later at 4 minutes and 42 seconds. So just as I said, if you have sprints, at least on a tier 6, whether you cancel drift over and over or you just go the lazy way with sprint, it's pretty much the same time. Now, as I'm sure some of you will point this out in the comments, I would like to mention that yes, I know I'm not one of the faster drift cancel people in the game. I've seen videos of other players just spamming or, you know, canceling drift so fast that you don't even see the animation happening. I am not one of those people. For me, you can see when I drift and, you know, it's not a very fast drift cancel, but in any case, it should be consistent for both horses, so yeah, it works. It just works. Now, for the number itself, which is probably what you wanted to hear all this time, the tier 8 is about 28.4% faster than the tier 6. Is this what you were expecting? Maybe, maybe not. I personally, myself, didn't think much of the difference. I thought it's maybe, what, 15%, something like that. But it turns out 28%, let's say around it 30% faster, it's actually quite noticeable. So if you have a tier 6 and want to get a tier 8, it's worth upgrading to a tier 8. Now, before I end the video, I have one last question, request. If anyone watching this video has a dream horse, I know the chance to get one is very, very low, but if anyone has a dream horse, if you are interested in doing this exact same racetrack from Heidel to Sankin Bazaar, sticking to the road, would you be willing to leave a comment with how much time it takes for a dream horse to do this exact same path? Because I want to know if a dream horse is noticeably faster than a tier 8, or if it's something incremental like 5% or at most 10% faster. That's something that I can't test for myself, and I would like to know if anyone wants to contribute. Besides that, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, leave it a dislike. If you didn't enjoy the video, leave it a like. Subscribe if you want to see different type of content, because I'm probably not going to race horses anymore. I'll see you in a different video, which will most likely be another spot review. And until then, stay happy, keep playing Black Desert, and bye bye.